Welcome to The Breakdown. I'm your host, Bethel Duran, joined today by Virgil Ortiz, the boxer, Virgil Ortiz, the trainer slash father or father trainer. We'll figure out the order of that right now. Today's show, what we're going to do is going to break down a fight that Virgil had and hear from the people that were there that night. The man who was in the ring, the man that was in the corner, the man who helped prepare for it. But before we get going on that, Virgil's going to be fighting August 6th at Dickies Arena in Fort Worth, Texas. Not too far where he grew up in Grand Prairie. He's taking on Michael McKinson. Virgil, as the fight gets closer and you're doing everything else and you're looking back at it, you prepare for your next opponent. But do you ever go back and look at your past fights?
All the time. I do it all the time. Yeah, even like some of my first fights, like my first five fights sometimes. Just to look back how much I've grown, what I'm still doing, you know, wrong or whatever. You know, I just like to see. I can never stop learning.
And father slash trainer, the same thing?
Yeah, I always go back and look at it. You can always go back and look at a fight even 100 times and just pay attention to the small details, feet, arms, reactions, blinks, gestures.
Blinks?
Yeah, some people blink when they punch or before they're gonna punch and when they do certain things. It's just little small stuff.
That's why we love doing the show, because picking up little details like that. I never, as a broadcaster, I never thought about looking at blinking. I'm thinking the blink is gonna hit hard. that too.
They usually, a lot of people do small stuff, you just pay attention to just what they do. It all depends on the category. Like a lot of fast people, for some reason, like to blink because they're trying too fast to go too fast, too hard to go too fast. And you can just see a lot of the stuff.
All right, there you go. Hopefully, I don't blink too much on this show. Now, for you, when you guys got the call to take on Mean Machine, what did you think about taking on that fight?
Oh, like we do every other fight. I mean, we just take it. I mean, they, again, you know, Rick Morrigan is Virgil's manager. His job is to get Virgil, you know, the path to the world title. And my job is just to train my son. I know what my son's capable of. I know what he is. You know, he's been doing this since he was five. So there's nothing new that he won't be able to see. The thing is, it's just the level of competition and what the guy brings is what we have to, you know, pretty much try to dissect.
And Virgil, for you, before we get into the video and do the breakdown of it, what kind of fight did you expect?
Exactly what we got. Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, when we got the fight, or when they mentioned it to me, I was actually really excited. There's certain fights that honestly excite me. So, and this was one of them.
Because you know it's going to be a...
I knew what kind of fight.
You knew there wasn't going to be no track meet here, right?
Exactly.
Like, you're not having... It's not cross country. You're not to find somebody.
Yeah.
So you want to get in there and mix it up.
Yeah.
Oh, man. They did that for sure. They put on a heck of a show in Texas last year. Let's look at the video now of Virgil Ortiz taking on the Mean Machine Kavaliauskas. And it was a good one. They went back and forth. And right there, start with you, Senior. What's it like for you, the dad, when you're in that corner as you're about to start the fight?
It's always, every fight's gonna be, you're always gonna have some kind of jitters. Just cause it's just normal. But really it's just more just trying to stay calm. If you're kind of jumpy, you know, the boxer, your son, whoever, they can feel it. So it's just more just trying to just stay calm and just watch how the other guy's looking at my son or reacting.
And your dad introduced you to the boxing. He's been your trainer day one. You've had different guys in your corners, but the dad is that's the voice you listen to. What was this like right away? Like, this is the veteran who came in. You're excited for it. But, man, it was, like, ugly in the beginning.
Yeah, it was. And, I mean, I feel like when it was happening, I was aware of everything, you know? I don't know how other people take it, but I was very aware right there. I slipped off of the weight of my own punch.
You got up real quick. You're like, nah.
Yeah, I'm like, nah, I'm good. But I mean, even right here, I kept my hands up. Like, all right, I'm pretty aware. I heard him with the body shot right there. I knew he was hurt. I kept going, maybe a little too recklessly. I slipped that punch really good, so you could tell how aware I was. But
he answers back, huh?
Yeah. I mean, he's a tough opponent. Mean Machine is, he lives up to his name.
The end of the round, what are you telling your son right here when you're like, okay?
Oh, I was pissed off. I was telling him. Oops, did I say that? I was telling him what the f*** wrong with him. I was telling him to stick to the, because, you know, the whole thing was to stick to the jab and go to the body a little bit later. He went too early. The guy was looking for it already, looking for the counter. So, you know, he should.
Right there.
Yeah, he was, I was just, no, I was mad that he came into the body too early. And that's, I knew that's, he was looking for the upper from the beginning. That's, we practiced this in the gym. So I just felt like he got a little, too confident, and you know, the guy can punch, and Virgil could, you know, he can feel the punches. He just got too confident that he was able to, you know, to eat the punches body-wise, feeling-wise.
And then the first drop right there, Virgil.
Yeah, it was a jab, pretty sharp jab.
And that, did you knew that's when it turned? Like, you just knew you had him right then?
I didn't necessarily have him, but I kind of, like, maybe settled him down a little bit.
I mean, you just turned around like, uh-huh. Like, I'm supposed to do this.
It was a weird jab, too. It kind of almost turned southpaw in a way.
Yeah, and then he came back at you. Yeah. You even had the little, come on.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm very competitive. I have a lot of pride, which could be a good and bad thing.
You're like, right now, so what are you thinking right here, Virgil? Having already dropped him once.
I believe this was the next round. I think I was just trying to, all right, let's start over how the fight was supposed to start. Off of the jab, keeping him out.
And then it calms down a little bit, senior?
Yeah, he started sticking to the plan and started using the jab. Again, the plan was to use the jab throughout the whole way and then start picking the shots here and there into the body and then start pouring it at the end. But, you know, with a guy like that, you gotta stay on the stick because he's looking for a fight and you don't want to get him what he wants yet. Not yet. You do it when you want to.
And Mean Machine's been in there tough. He's been in there with so many good names. And the step up in competition, this was a fight when it was announced, people were like, oh, that's good for Virgil. He's taking this fight on. And this is exactly what we expected, a back and forth battle. When did you feel like you were controlling this fight? Right there with that punch? No?
I don't know. I don't even know what round this is. I'm not too sure. I started like making him, you know what? It was like around this round where I started feeling like, all right, he can't hit me when he wants to hit me anymore. I can hit him whenever I want to hit him.
It looked like he was
even right here. He tried to like explode a little bit, but I didn't let him. And I think the round ends right here. Yeah, there we go. See, I've seen this fight so many times already. But this is the last round. Right here, I definitely felt him.
Yeah, just keep talking, Virgil. You led us down the way. You talk all you want.
The body shot, the jab to the body is a very underrated punch, and that's what put him down. He didn't. I mean, in all honesty, he didn't look as hurt as he seemed to be. I mean, I don't know. He just looked like he was backpedaling. I guess maybe the jab was a little harder than I thought it was going to be. I'd do another one. Another jab, just really trying to mix it up and down, so he doesn't know what's coming.
You're snapping your shots now.
Yeah, making sure to go to the body so he knows. Making him miss. I mean, at this point, I've pretty much, like, the momentum is all on my side now.
Yeah, the machine's getting broken down. Like, can you feel that it was going to end?
Not necessarily it was going to end, but that it was coming. And as long as I made the right shots, that it would end. Yeah, good left hook right there.
But he popped right back up, man.
Yeah, he was a tough guy. He's a tough guy.
He popped up, and he shakes his head like, how did I get caught with that? Like, he's telling the referee, like, all right, come on, let's just go. Yeah. Now what do you do?
I jump on him. I just jump on him right here. I try to surprise him. See, like I'm saying, like, when he got up, he didn't seem all shaky. Like, even right there, he doesn't seem shaky-legged. But as soon as I punched him, his leg was starting to give up.
You're hitting hard, aren't you?
I mean, I am, but he doesn't seem like he's hurt. He really doesn't. He's really good at playing it off. And right here, I think the 10-second bell had already landed, so I basically ran after him and took him out.
Yeah, and that's when, like that nod right there, senior, that, okay, the kid got me right there, right there. I did everything I could.
Yeah, you know, one thing that when I watched Kavaliauskas, I watched several of his fights over and over and over again, one thing that, and I told Virgil this, I told him that he was going to hurt him, and he wasn't going to know it. I told him, this guy is so good that when you hit him, he doesn't show it. I mean, he literally doesn't show no emotion, no like, good shot, or no, until the very end when he did, but you can't see nothing. So when you hit him, you have to really pay attention. The only way you're going to know is going to be very, very small, and he's only going to give it to you for 1/4 of a second. It ain't going to be very much. So you just have to fight him like he's just on it. I mean, you just have to be on it because he doesn't show no He doesn't show no vulnerability as when he's hurt at all.
And his nickname is Mean Machine for a reason. For you, the trainer who were preparing your son and your fighter for this fight, you just said it. You expected this. When you're in the corner and it's happening, what's that feeling like?
It's a good thing and it's a bad thing. It's a good thing because obviously you know what's happening and you're almost predicting it. But it's a bad thing because you can also know what the outcome can happen too. You know a little mistake, a mishap, what he's still capable of. I mean, the man is still fully capable of being himself from the first round even into the last round because he has so much Olympic experience. He's a lot older. He's been with guys, against like a Crawford and you just know he has that man strength. My son doesn't have man strength yet. He's still a baby for me. He's still a puppy. But he's also, the other guy's also more mature upstairs. You know, he knows.
He's been there.
Yeah, he knows. He can be in a firefight and still know it. Like, I still got him right. I don't have him necessarily where I want him, but I still have him coming to my trap, you know. Yeah. So it's just small stuff like that.
And Virgil, for you, when the fight's over, I've always said it, Virgil Ortiz doesn't show emotion after a fight. He can knock you out, he can destroy you, and it's like, there you go. But that one, you felt a little bit different, right? Like, yeah. That one was like, man, I had to earn this in a good way. You liked it.
Yeah, I mean, it's different when you feel like you earned it, you know, when it's a tough fight. I mean, my favorite national championship was the 2013 Junior Olympics, and that's because I had the hardest bracket of literally, like...
You remember that still, huh?
I do. I had a fight...
That was like almost a decade ago. You remember?
I remember a lot of things.
That's good.
Random stuff, but... That I had to face all the hard guys in the bracket, like it was made perfectly where I had to fight every single one of them back to back to back, and I beat them all. And that little medal means more to me than that 40-pound belt I have.
It's the challenge is what you love.
Yeah.
Nothing easy.
No.
Man, you are really a different breed. Great job by you, the trainer and father, getting him locked in like that, man.
Oh well, I mean it's a team. It's me. It's a Hector Beltran, you know, is our old coach, Gene Vivero, that passed, his brother, Yuli. You know, we've had a very good team that has been assembled. And, you know, luckily for me, I was able to learn off of them because they also have experience in different parts of the game. And our game just happened to mesh very well when we all worked together.
All right. Hey, the breakdown. Love hearing from you, man. I definitely want to hear more from you because the way that you approach the fight, like, it's pretty cool, man. Loves hearing it. The breakdown, Virgil Ortiz Sr., Virgil Ortiz Jr., you'll be able to watch them fight in Fort Worth, Texas, August 6th against Michael McKinson. For both of these guys, I'm Beth Durant. Thanks for watching The Breakdown.